We start the drape here. So first of all, I'll make the neck over here. Get two lines from here also. So you take a round turn to show the back. Take the shape. I'm making a drape dressed over here. From this side, we take the armhole. From this side also, you take some length. Take some length over here as well. Take this side like that. Take this inside. Make dashes so that drapes look prominent. From this side, we are taking a turn and when you come till this side, you take a turn inside so that it drapes on the body. When it falls on the body, this will uplift, this will stand out. Here you put a notch and give this direction so that it looks the drape. Once you come here, put some dashes up. Here also give a dash like that. Take a turn up. Take this side a bit outside, a bit bulge and move this up. And join this side with that. So this will become outside part and this will turn inside. Here what you do is you show the overlapping. Here the skin will show. We come down and take a turn. Here also you push this up. Push this up from this side. Take this down. And from this side also take it up like that. Move it up, take this side outside and move this up. Once you reach here, take this side back and move it down. So I'll make it with pen and then I erase it and then we'll design a belt over here. I'm making it with 0.2 pen actually over here, which is a liner pen, taking the drapes out. Take this up, bring this down. Give some notches, take a turn from here, keep the body curve intact, this will go back, this will come inside, make a dash over here, make a dash over here, show this like a cavity. Make them very smooth. These curve has to come very smooth actually. It depends on the fabric fall as well. This will come out and give a bulge over here. Now we need to show this part which is inside. So what we'll do is we'll put some dashes from here. This will come up. And from this side, we put some lines. And you can make these lines also to show that it is inside part or there is a fold inside. So these will become dark. It will look like this is inside. Now I'm going to make this side. Here also you see the body curve and it's moving from here to here, so we have to get the lines from here. Suppose the drape is coming from this side, so you move here and you take a turn inside. Look at the body curve and our hand should move accordingly. Here also you take a turn and move it here. Make a line. Bring this over here. Take this back. Bring the body curve over here. Take this inside. Make this outside and take a turn inside. Make some lines. Give this up. Take a turn up, bring this down. From this side you take a turn outside and bring it inside. This looks the bulge of the fabric. Here we have already made the folds over here. Now after you reach at this point you need to show a belt. So I'll make the belt first and then we do the rest of the part of the drape. So here the belt will form. So I'll see the turn of the belt, which is like that. And there is this buckle, which will come outside. We give this a double line. We make the buckle bigger, a big size buckle. Now you see the body curve and move the belt accordingly. The belt will come like that. Give this a thickness also, the belt. Give this a turn. Give the same thing over here. But what you need to do is to show there is a flap which will come, which will hold the other end of the belt. This will go inside. This will go inside. This will come outside and this will come outside. And there is this flap which will go inside. Now make it with pen. I'm giving some design to the buckle, which we can obviously enhance at the end and make it look like there are some jewels over here. Some embellishment you can do on the belt that it will look nice. you give the thickness of the belt and you give the stitch line also. So you try to give almost all the details to the belt. The buckle of flap will come out like that. It will go inside like this. The belt will come here. And from one side you make it thick, so that it looks like there is a thickness of the belt over here. And give the stitch line. After giving the stitch line, it looks nice. Give the round shape. Take this round. Give the stitch line over here also. Now we come to the downside. We come to this side. So here we see the drape, and first we make the notches. Suppose the drape is moving. So first you make dashes to get the drape and the seam done. Actually the seam. Give one dash over here. Give one dash over here. Show if there you want to show a pocket. Like this will go back, this will come inside. Similarly, we can do this from here. This will come inside, this will go outside. Now first make the drapes over here. This part is very important. Take a dash inside like that. This is the first side of the pant. So it will move according to the body curve, as we have discussed this before. This will again come here and move it down with a steep curve, which will come inside like that. Now I will take a flap here, move this down, and bring this like a curve over here. We see this seam and we make the first side of the pant bifurcation. But this bifurcation is moving inside, that is the reason our lines will come here and it will move from there. Now the lines will turn, it will take a turn like that. Like this. Not much, only a few turn. This will be clear once I'll use my pen. So now I'm making the flap go like this. And there is this part which will come and join. Yeah. So I'll just show this drape with the pen. Thank you. take a turn here, bring this here and take a sharp turn from this side, bring this straight, match it with this point and make it like that. The inner other curves will come like that. So once you reach here, this will come inside and join. Bring the flap. If I raise the side, you will come to know what happened over here. This is how the drape will look like from one side. This will get more clear once we paint this side. Because in painting you will get to see how the turn is there and how the drape is coming. Now from this side we have made a turn. Make this inside. Now here the pant turn is like that because the leg is at front. Here the pant turn will be straight. So this is what we need to keep in mind. So we always move with the curve when it comes to the draping. Like this will get a straight turn. If you want to show nice drape, then you have to make a lot of line. Now what will happen here is that there is this fall which will come. So you have to take a turn at the knee. And here the turns will come to this side and take a flap. Now here there is the fabric is clinging, so wherever it clings we give this curve, which is very important to get the curve over here. And curves should be very smooth because the fabric is very smooth. See, my hand moves very smoothly, so you should try to move your hand like that. Take this turn over here and get the fabric, slight turn from this side so that it shows the tension, because the fabric will stretch at the back, the fabric will stretch. So here somewhere we can draw our feet. And at the back you can draw the feet over here. I will erase this side also, so that it becomes very clear how this drape is coming. And that's how the draping is done. I hope you guys have understood and will do a good job and then show it to me.